A lot to do, so let's get on with it. And where better to start than right at the beginning with a round of questions on Adam and Eve. Whether or not you believe in them, they are quite interesting, which is all we ask on this programme. Like God, as Woody Allen said, how can I believe in God when just last week I got my tongue caught in the roller of an electric typewriter? Carrie Snow, the American comedian, said, if God was a woman, sperm would taste of chocolate. But, perhaps... I don't understand it either. Perhaps we...
As you know, it doesn't.
Oh, he knows.
Damn. But perhaps, you know, we should believe in Adam and Eve. Geneticists have established that every woman in the world shares a single female ancestor who lived 150,000 years ago. Scientists do actually call her Eve, and every man shares a single male ancestor dubbed Adam. It's also been established, however, that Adam was born 80,000 years after Eve. So the world before him was one of heavy to industrial strength lesbianism, one assumes. Now, the first question goes to Alan. What is the connection between the Archbishop of Canterbury's left ear and Adam's belly button?
His ear, the ear and the belly button. God, just as you said that, there was a painting came up.
We do this, I'm afraid, yeah. I'm not going to ask who did the painting. That would be an insult.
Adam's on the left.
Yes, well done.
That's his belly button there.
It would seem.
And the Archbishop of Canterbury's ear.
Yeah.
The only time I can ever think where you'd put your ear to someone's belly button would be to hear if their tummy was rumbling. Yes. You go, your tummy's rumbling, you're hungry, aren't you?
True.
Is that what it is?
I'm afraid... I don't want to astonish you, but I'm afraid it isn't.
Is it because Adam wouldn't have had a belly button, would he, being the first man? And neither of the Archbishop of Canterbury's got an idea.
He's good, isn't he? I'm going to give him 3 points for that. The fact is, they're both purely decorative. Adam, of course, cannot have had a navel because he was created. He wasn't born. Mm-hmm. So there wouldn't have been an umbilical cord.
You're saying the Archbishop of Canterbury's left ear is purely decorative?
He describes it himself. It's purely decorative. He was born deaf in the left ear, so it has no... Right, no function.
If his left ear is purely decorative,
yes,
it's very unimaginative for him just to have an ear there, isn't it? Anything he wanted there at all.
A donut or another
organ, like a hand.
A badminton racket, I would have said.
A badminton racket or a shuttlecock. A road sign. A little chiclet.
Or rather, sort of surreally, a portrait of Van Gogh.
Ah. Yeah, he could have had Van Gogh.
Was missing. Yeah.
He'd have a little Van Gogh there, saying, as if to say, do you see?
Mm. Very good. Very good. Well, we've got something out of the wreckage. I'm inclined.
Who painted that picture?
1475 till 1564. I hate myself for saying that. Who? Those are his dates.
He's quite correct. Michelangelo Buonarroti. We have to give 5 points to Johnny Sessions for knowing the birth and death dates of Michelangelo.
So sad.
We also have to hate him, incidentally.
Yes.
Very impressed. No. You can do this. I've done this with John Sessions at parties. When was Bruckner born?
1824, died 1896.
You see? Isn't it wonderful?
Weird. Marla. 1860, born July the 7th in Kalist in Austria. Died 1911 in Kalist in Austria.
It's a horrible sickness.